Hi everyone, myself Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. So today I have a lot of interesting news to share with you guys, but before that, those who are coming for the first time, let me tell you that you can join our Telegram group as well as you can subscribe to this channel so that you can get connected with us. And in order to get the instant updates about our channel, you can hit this bell notification. And on this Telegram channel, we provide free quizzes and you can also connect with us. And if you have any kind of queries, you can ask your queries there as well as in the comment section mentioned below. And the description link and the link of this Telegram channel will be provided in the description box below. So let's start with the video with this first question. And this first question is about a remarkable announcement that Prime Minister Narendra Modi has done recently. So what is that announcement? Let's discuss that. PM Narendra Modi has announced to increase the refining capacity of India from around 250 million tons per annum to dash by 2025. So this announcement by Prime Minister Narendra Modi was made during India Energy Forum. So this India Energy Forum was organized by CERAWE organization. Do remember the name of the organization that has organized this week. It is CERAWE. So this organization has organized this forum where PM Narendra Modi has announced India's plan and the futuristic plan of central government that it aims to increase the refining capacity of India to 400 million tons per annum. So this is the answer of this question. And by which year does India want to increase the refining capacity to 400 MTPA? It is by 2025. Do remember the year as well. So here, this news ends because we have done everything about the news. Now we should also have a glance over the static facts. So guys, do you know that India is the third largest importer of oil in the world? And of LNG, that is liquefied natural gas, India is the fourth largest importer in the world. Now your task is to find out that which two countries precede India in terms of oil import and which three countries precede India in terms of LNG imports. In case you find any kind of trouble in finding the right answers, then do let me know in the comment section below. And for the time being, let's move on to the next question. So this question is very interesting because it is about a tunnel, and what is so special about this tunnel, that I will tell you after I will tell you the answer of this question. So let's first discuss the question. Which two countries will be joined by the Fehmarn Belt tunnel? So this new tunnel is going to be built, and this tunnel is going to join Germany and Denmark. So these are the two countries which will be joined by this new Fehmarn Belt tunnel. Now, what is so special about this tunnel? Guys, do listen to me very carefully. This tunnel is going to be the world's longest immersed tunnel. So what is the meaning of immersed? Immersed means that it is going to be developed below sea. So this is the world's longest immersed tunnel. Now we are talking about it being the longest immersed tunnel. So what is the length of this tunnel? It is 18 kilometers. Apart from this, it is also the world's longest combined road and railway tunnel. So these two facts about this tunnel are very, very important. So do note it down, do memorize these facts, that it is going to be the world's longest immersed tunnel of 18 kilometers, and it is the world's longest combined road and railway tunnel. And this tunnel is going to have two roads, road tunnels and two electrified rail tunnels. So this is a very basic fact that I have told you. You are not required to remember this thing, but do remember these two points. So we have covered the larger part of this news. Now you would be very curious to know the exact location of this tunnel, because I have mentioned that this tunnel is going to be built below sea. So which sea? Let's discuss that. So this is the map, and this is the Farmenbelt tunnel. So this is the German island, and lowland is the Denmark island, and this is the tunnel that is going to be developed, and this will link these two island nations. And this is the sea, Baltic Sea, where it is going to be developed. So it is going to be developed 40 meters deep down the sea, that is the Baltic Sea. So do remember the sea as well. A question might come up on the sea or on these islands. However, the chances of it are quite meager, but still you have to remember the meager facts as well. So that is all about this question. I hope that this map helps you in envisioning the tunnel. Now let's discuss the third question. Which organization has released the Global Wealth Report 2020? So this report has been recently released, and it mentions that despite COVID-19, India and China has performed really well in terms of household wealth. So first of all, let's discuss the answer of this question, and then we will be discussing the quite important announcement or the quite important highlights of this report. So which organization has released it? It is Credit Suisse. So option D is the right answer. Now this report tells us that despite COVID-19, when the income of everyone in the world is going down, India and China has performed really well. So India's household wealth has increased by 4.4%, and China's household wealth has increased by 1.6%. Now guys, for this report, this is the major fact that you need to mug up from your exam point of view. There were other facts as well, but in my perspective, this fact is the most important fact, and other facts are not very important because they are of very generic nature. So a question might come up on these facts, so memorize these facts, and the other generic nature facts are covered in the Spotlight magazine. So you can download that magazine from the website. Now guys, one thing is that do remember the headquarters of this Credit Suisse organization. Where is it located? Now it is not very important from the exam point of view. If you want to know the headquarters of Credit Suisse, you can get additional knowledge in order to gain your enhance your knowledge base, but there is no need as such of remembering the Credit Suisse's headquarters. But in case if you want, then you can find out the headquarters of Credit Suisse. Now next question is, with which sport is Lewis Hamilton related to? So why is he here in the news? Now guys, if you are following the Spotlight magazine for quite some period of time, so you would know that he is a very famous name, and he appears quite often in the Spotlight magazine. Because of the victories that he has registered. So which victories? He is a sportsman in which field? So basically he is a motorsport player, motorsport racer, and recently by winning the Portuguese Grand Prix, he has registered his 92nd victory, and by registering his 92nd victory, he has become the world's best Formula motorsport racer, F1 motorsports racer. So that is why he is very important from the exam point of view. A question might come up from Lewis Hamilton. So do remember that he is a motorsport player and his nationality is British. एंड ही हैज़ वन दी 92 मोटर स्पोर्ट ग्रैंड प्रिक्स टूर्नामेंट्स टिल दिस डेट. ऑफ कोर्स ही इज़ गोइंग टू विन द मोटर स्पोर्ट रेस इन द फ्यूचर इज वेल. सो टिल द टाइम द एग्जाम कम्स आई विल बी टेलिंग यू हाउ मैनी विक्ट्रीज हैज़ ही रजिस्टर्ड इन हिज नेम. बट फॉर द टाइम बिंग यू हैव टू रिमेंबर दैट ही हैज़ रजिस्टर्ड 92 विन्स एंड फॉर एंड प्रेजेंटली ही इज़ द वर्ल्ड्स बेस्ट Formula One racer. So he's the most successful for F1 driver in history in terms of wins. So these are the pictures of five most successful Formula One racers. Now you are not required to memorize these pictures, this picture, because this picture I have put here because I found it very interesting and I wanted to show it to you guys. Don't memorize the facts mentioned here. Just remember the facts about Lewis Hamilton that I have told you in the previous slide. Now comes our next question, again from the sports section. Which country has won the gold in the women's category in the Asian Nations Regions Online Chess Championship 2020? Since it's an online chess tournament, therefore no need to remember any kind of venue. There is no venue. That's a plus point for us guys, because here one thing has reduced for us to remember. So this is the online chess tournament, and Indian women has really made us proud. They have won the gold medal in this Asian chess championship, and in men's category, Australia has won the gold and Indian men had won silver. So do remember this thing that women won the gold in this Asian Nations Regions Online Chess Championship 2020. In men's, Australia won the gold and Indian men won the silver. That's all for this question. Let's move on to the last question. Who has won the Egypt Open 2020 in men's category? First of all, this Egypt Open is a squash tournament. So there are a lot of tournaments by the name Open. So don't confuse here, because there is an Open with the name of an Open which is organized by PGA, Professional Golf Association. So that's the Golf Opens, that is the Golf Open tournaments. Then there is ITF Open which is organized by Tennis Federation, and this is the Squash Open which is organized by PSA, Professional Squash Association. So these are the various opens that are being organized, and this Egyptian Open is a squash tournament. Now, who has won this in the men's category? It is again Ali Farag, who is an Egyptian. So he is an Egyptian. So basically this golf, this squash tournament happened in Egypt, and an Egyptian has won this in men's category. Now who is the winner in women's category? It is again an Egyptian. So she is also an Egyptian who has won this Egyptian Open golf tournament in women's category, Noor El Sherbini. So that's all for the session today. I hope that you have really liked the session, and if you have, then do subscribe to this channel and do like this video and come for the video tomorrow as well. Thank you so much for watching the video.